Captain.
Let's get you out of here, Traeger. Come on.
We're gonna make it home, sir?
You bet we are.
Check forward damage control.
Yes, sir.
You weren't trying to save Traeger, were you, sir? There's no outpost close enough for him to reach. I want you to address the crew. Tell them I'm now in command of the ship.
Sure you want her, Vance? Kind of messed her up.
Rest in peace, Jacob Brown. We'll be right back.
number holders will be notified by
the phone. We are continuing to call
if they are available.
So what'd you get?
Well, I got tens. I got straight tens on everything except psychosocial adjustments.
Well, what exactly did Dr. Morgan say?
That a 9.3 is very good for someone 5 years younger than his classmates. And that I'm, quote, very advanced for someone born in the year 2074.
Well, then.
Ooh!
Ooh?
Every time you say, well, then, like that, you follow it by something completely rational.
Yeah.
Well, I don't feel like being rational right now, Jonathan. I feel like I'm sick of being a kid genius.
You're not. I was a kid genius.
What?
You are a kid super genius whose science grades are still breaking records.
I'm old.
Well, then.
I wanted that pen, Jonathan.
As within safe zone for all categories other than those otherwise notified. As we have been for the last 17 hours, we are continuing to call your attention to an HW470 condition.
Got it?
Repeat, HW470 condition. Tonight's forecast, scattered showers and acceptable oxygen level.
Yeah, sure. I hate this stuff.
You're not breathing.
You sure?
Deep.
I got your purse.
Excuse us.
Here's your purse.
Are you all right, ma'am?
Thanks. Oh, so silly. When I left home, I forgot my breather.
Oh, I've got an extra one.
Well, thank you. Oh, don't want to trouble you.
Is there anything else we can do for you, ma'am?
Oh, don't you worry about me. I'll be all right. I'll just sit right here for a few minutes, and I'll be as right as rain.
Excuse me?
Oh, it's only an old expression, dear. You wouldn't remember it.
Well, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Right
as rain.
Thanks, Jonathan. Sugar level is 0.7 above medium. Also advise reduction of salt intake by 1.5. Affirmative.
Affirmative.
Your order?
Veggie Bio Burger, the works.
Bio Burger, famous French fries, algae chip.
No.
I'll take those.
Change that, yes.
Drink.
Nutrishake.
With or without BioCycline?
Without, end of order.
Please use table 03, thank you. Account overdrawn, repeat overdrawn.
What do you mean account overdrawn? I made a deposit just this afternoon.
Account overdrawn, repeat overdrawn. Next customer, please.
Jonathan.
No.
Please, lend me your hand. I'll pay you back.
This is the third time this week, Bean.
I've had a stressful day. My blood sugar's low.
Oh, you used that one last time.
Hey, Jonathan. Sugar level 0.7 above medium. Your order, please.
Three super burgers with extra sauce. A Nutri-Shake, two LG chips with Dyna Dip, one Benzo Shake, a Therma Chips with amino sauce.
See, the problem is, I'm competing against myself. Every class I take, I keep raising the curve. No matter how well I do, they expect me to do better.
They also expect you to get around to taking a few classes outside your major, Beanie.
Like music appreciation.
Requirements, Beanie. You can't keep putting them off forever.
I could break into the computer transcripts and put that I've already taken those classes.
Don't even think about it.
I wouldn't really do it. But it sure makes things a lot more fun. I'm going this hour?
Your priority. Come on.
Thank you for eating at Maya Burgers, a division of Fujiyama Hydroponic Farms of Akron,
Ohio. Let's go. Pretty briefing command. Priority briefing command.
This isn't our flight group.
I know.
Who are these people?
I recognize a few of them. Just the ones in my classes.
Beanie, do you have any idea what's going on? Why, Lonnie? Not a clue. Who's that?
La Sanzon, friend of mine. He's cute.
Sally? I don't know if you remember me. I'm Jonathan Hayes.
Jonathan, yes, I remember you. You went on to command school, didn't you?
Yeah. Sorry to hear about your brother.
Thank you.
What happened to your brother?
He was on the Vanguard Explorer.
Oh, sorry. I'm Huxley Wells, navigation.
Sally Arthur, MD.
This is Jesse Beanstalk.
Beanstalk?
Yeah, P5 full farm. They call me Beanie.
Lonnie Maiori, Flight Control School. This is Les.
Hi.
I've heard about you, haven't I? You're the IQ kid with the alien life forms fixation.
He likes little green men.
Attention! Cadets, be seated. And may I offer my congratulations on your outstanding achievement records. They've qualified you to serve aboard the Earth Star Voyager. Voyager is our newest interstellar ship. I have the honor to have been appointed her captain. Latest projections indicate a worsening of our outer radiation belts. They're about to hit maximum, where they will remain for 5 years.
But, sir, why not wait the 5 years?
Look outside, Jonathan. This planet's in trouble. Before she vanished 6 years ago, Vanguard Explorers sent out probes. We've just received a report from one of them. It gave us the location of that Berenson star. And in orbit around it is a planet we've named Demeter. We haven't been able to decode all the information yet. This is the best picture we can give you. We have some readings of an acceptable atmosphere, but we're still not sure if it can support life. Voyager's mission is to answer that question, because if Demeter is suitable, we're going to have to move there. It'll take at least 40 years to build the ships necessary to move everyone. And the star's 18.7 light years away.
A trip like that, even with fusion generators and the Bauman drive, that'd take at least...
25 years round trip.
26, Beanie. We're factoring in a year for exploration of the planet.
I'll be 40.
Cryogenic sleep will be available to all crew members. For every 3 days we spend on the trip, we'll only age 2, but we will age. That's why we've made our selections from the Academy, because you're all young. And if telemetry indicates I'm past my peak, then Jonathan will be captain on the return voyage.
All right!
Now, if the radiation projections are accurate, once we're out there, we won't be able to communicate with Earth.
Sir, what are the weapon specifications?
This is a peaceful mission of exploration, Jonathan. Weapons are not a high priority.
But the OTZ, sir.
The Outlaw Technology Zone controlled half this planet and came very close to controlling the other half before we beat them.
There was rumor of an OTZ outpost.
The outpost was discovered 2 years ago and destroyed by Triton Corsair.
Admiral Beasley's ship? Is he still out there?
Yes, Huxley. In fact, he conceived Earth Star Voyager and personally selected each of you for this mission. We will leave in 48 hours.
So that's it, Gretchen. We're only allowed this one call. I just wanted you to know that I'll never forget you.
I'll be fine.
There was that one time, you couldn't have been more than 3. You kept saying you wanted more chalky ice cream. That's what you called chocolate.
Mom!
And your father thought it was so cute, the way you kept saying chalky, he kept giving it to you. You spent the whole night throwing up.
I can't ask you to wait for me, Marion. But I wanted you to know I'll never forget you.
I might never see you again.
Mom, you...
I'm proud of you, and I love you. I guess that's really about it.
Mom. Thank you. For everything. I love you too.
I mean, I'll be thinking of you, Roxanne.
The name is Jeannie, thanks.
Well, of course it's Jeannie. I knew that. It's just that I always think of you as a Roxanne. I mean, it suits you so much better than Jeannie. Then who's Roxanne?
You say goodbye to your boyfriend?
He'll wait for you. Anyone would.
I don't have a boyfriend.
Who did you call?
My parents. I'll probably never have one now.
What?
A boyfriend.
What do you think all those crew members with short hair are? You've got 26 years. I'd say your chances are better than a 50-50.
Aboard. I'd like you to meet Brody Arnold, physical fitness technician. This is your command team.
Jonathan Hayes.
Do you have my promise? You'll end this voyage in better shape than you started. You'll excuse me, sir? Excuse me.
Built like that, he's got to be a real souffle in the brain department.
Look at this. 40 lounges, 3 libraries, an interdenominational chapel, and a nursery.
You know, as captain, I have the power to perform marriage ceremonies.
Is it mandatory?
The whole purpose of this mission is to ensure the survival of the species. Follow me, and I'll show you the bridge.
Don't worry, I'll handle your quota.
Isn't he a bit young for you?
Can I send some?
Yeah.
Well, here it is. Home sweet home.
This is incredible.
Hello, Beanie.
Priscilla? Priscilla, you on this ship?
Who else, Beanie?
Wow, that's super!
That's the supercomputer?
Oh, Priscilla, I'd like you to meet Huxley.
Hello, Huxley. I've been reading your records over and over.
How'd she get my records?
Excuse me, Captain Forbes. The Triton Corsair has just arrived alongside. It is in parallel orbit with Earthstar Voyager, and Admiral Beasley requests permission to address the crew.
Bring it in, please.
Officers and crew of Earthstar Voyager, the importance of your mission dwarfs anything I can say to you. Nonetheless, I offer my best wishes and my thanks, because now Triton Corsair can get on with a mission of her own. I chose you all for this voyage. Do me proud. I wish I were young enough to go with you. But of course I will be with you in spirit. Yes, Lieutenant Matthews.
Standing by for navigational coordinates, sir.
Plot course 219L475W and put Earth Star Voyager on my screen.
Good luck, Voyager. You're going to need it.
Guidance report.
Flight path clear, Mr. Hayes.
Bioscience?
All crew members read positive, Mr. Hayes.
Telemetry and navigational, Mr. Wells.
Trajectory 39AX24B, plotted in, John.
Sir?
Your ship, Captain Forbes.
Just one second, sir. Propulsion status report, Mr. Beanstalk.
Fusion thrust engines and Bowman drive check, sir.
Now, Captain Forbes.
Sorry.
All engines boost.
Mr. Beanstalk, compensate acceleration, please.
Yes, sir.
Worked again.
What's that?
Antique silver dollar. It's my lucky charm. It does tricks.
Watch it, Huxley.
That's wonderful, Huxley.
Not to mention original.
Oh, then maybe you like this.
Fingers. Captain Forbes, permission to break, Mr. Wells. Approaching junk belt.
Space pollution at its finest.
Deflection shields, Mr. Hayes.
Standard course plotted on screen, sir. Estimated crossing time, 10 minutes.
And you'll see some speed.
It's a mess, isn't it?
No other way to dispose of it.
All station alert.
Disturbance.
Specify.
Voyager's fusion thrust is affecting the junk orbit. They're starting to destabilize.
Shields to maximum. Check power systems under load.
Mr. Wells, available evasive course.
Autopilot scanning for clear passage.
Look out! Forbes, shields are moving towards overload.
Shields to intermittent.
But, sir, some of it could get through.
If we don't lessen the power drain, all of it will get through.
Huxley, get us on another course.
There are none. The radiation belt is closing them off.
Then give me manual control now.
Manual control.
No further obstructions.
Yeah!
Nice work.
I didn't think we could do that with a ship this big.
I didn't either. Damage report, Mr. Beanstalk.
Damage at 6 locations, including airlock number 3. Deploying repair crews now. Sir.
I'll go supervise. Looks like you've got things under control.
Jonathan, let's not ever do that again, okay?
don't know when they taught you that, but I'm glad you didn't cut class that day.
I learned that when I was 7 years old, playing dodger.
Repairs completed?
All patched up, Captain. Mr. Beanstalk said to proceed to Sector 5.
Carry on.
Inner door secure. Space ejection process commencing.
Forbes to bridge. Captain Forbes calling the bridge.
Prepare for egress.
Bridge, malfunction in outer airlock 3. Jonathan. Jonathan, can you hear me?
Prepare for egress.
That's okay. I mean, you don't have to. And so I was born in this town in Switzerland.
She's a really nice girl.
She's genius.
Well, sure. I mean...
Beanie.
Excuse me.
Can't get a reading from number 3 airlock.
They've completed repairs. They just called in.
Nice repair job. Beanie, I'm gonna wanna talk to the team that worked on that airlock.
Bridge. Forbes to bridge. Captain Forbes calling the bridge. Jonathan!
Airlock 3, all station alert. Airlock 3.
Jonathan, listen to me.
Egress in 10 seconds. Warning, decompression commencing.
What happened?
I don't know. Look, Jonathan, complete the mission.
Keep going. Promise me. Airlock 3, cut sector power, terminate egress.
Do it.
Promise you will. Keep going.
Egress completed.
How much damage?
We're still trying to evaluate, sir, but we do have a report of one fatality.
Captain Forbes is dead.
Sir.
Thank you, Mr. Krieger. Keep me advised.
Sir.
So now Mr. Hayes is captain. I hope I was right.
Check it again, but I know I'm right.
Thank you. Your repairs have been confirmed. You weren't responsible. You may go.
Yes, sir.
Jonathan, I certified the airlock door myself. There's no way it could have jammed.
But it did. Maybe you forgot something.
I didn't forget anything. I went over everything twice. It had to be a computer malfunction. What do we do now?
I don't know.
It's your decision, Captain.
Well, do we abort the mission or do we go on?
We can't abort.
Got it. It's right here. They buried it in one of the other programs, but it's an airlock door command. That's not my entry code. Jonathan, this was no accident. Somebody did it on purpose.
Who would want to kill Captain Forbes?
Starboard radar sensor needs extravehicular repairs now. Huxley's scanning for someplace with docking facilities.
I'm Dr. Leland Eugene.
Okay, I'll be here for this.
Mental health officer, I believe you wanted to see me, Captain.
I'm sorry we haven't met sooner. What do people usually call you, Leland, Lee?
Dr. Eugene.
I see. Well, Dr. Eugene, I want a full biopsych review of all crew members.
Why do you ask?
Because of Captain Forbes.
I assure you, I went over every mental fitness profile myself. I'm sure that as you gain experience, you'll find that accidents of this sort can always be attributed to the technical staff. Faulty maintenance, shoddy repair work.
I want to see your report in 2 hours, Doctor.
2 hours? There are 116 people on board.
115.
Nonetheless, I couldn't possibly finish for at least 24 hours, even then.
2 hours.
Jonathan? Are you all right?
Yeah. Sure. Fine. Truth is, I'm scared, Beanie.
I know.
I'm not sure I can handle this.
Sure you can. That's why they put you here.
I wish I had your confidence.
Anytime you need it, you got it.
Thanks, Beanie.
That's what study partners are for, right?
Yeah.
We're coming up on Blue Star Gamma. I think it's what we're looking for.
Well, of course it is, Huxley.
Abandoned 40 years ago, and it's still generating power.
Priscilla, give me an image.
Sorry it took so long.
That's all right.
I find no information about the stability of its orbit.
Jonathan, we're gonna need to make extravehicular repairs.
It's got docking facilities.
Captain, there's a life force present. It could be dangerous.
I wonder if it's maybe...
Little green men in a flying saucer? Hungry little green men?
Huxley, be serious.
Let's go for it. Mr. Wells, while repairs are going on, you and I'll investigate.
Repairs.
What kind of life force could survive here?
Not even Beanie's little green men.
Jonathan.
It might not be green, but it eats. Where you came. Jonathan, what's going on?
There's an antimatter field right in front of you.
Watch out, Jonathan.
Cleared for entry. No further action. IO system scan for ID, please.
Captain Jacob Dryden Brown, Space Science Academy, class of 2074, graduated third in class.
I got a C in weightlessness training, brought down my grade point average.
Appointed captain of spacecraft Vanguard Explorer in year 2080. Ship vanished in 2082. All aboard, declare dead.
Surprise.
Captain Brown, did anyone else from the Explorer survive? My brother was on your ship. Lieutenant Vance Arthur.
Sorry. What happened to your ship?
It was destroyed.
Then how did you escape?
The capsule.
So much for the captain going down with his ship.
It's all right with you. I think I better talk with your commanding officer.
I'm the commanding officer.
How long before we get back to Earth?
26 years. We're on an exploratory mission to Berenson Star.
It's just my luck. Finally hitch a ride and I'm going in the wrong direction.
It's better than where you were.
Kindergarten? Do you ever feel a compulsion that's let's say...
Look, I can save you some time here. Yes, no, maybe, none of your business. You can fill in those answers any way you want.
Your brainwave profile suggests possible delayed stress trauma.
Really? Come to think of it, there is one thing. Lately, I've been getting this weird urge, you know? Like I want to start throwing things around, bashing heads together.
Is there any particular stimulus that brings on this urge?
People who ask questions.
Dr. Eugenia, I'm ready if you'd like to continue this later.
Let me guess. You're gonna tell me he's really a nice guy once I get to know him.
No. He's always like that. Take off your clothes, please.
Does that mean I'm forgiven?
Your clothes, Captain. Or I can put you in quarantine for the next few years.
This is a shower?
Ultrasound. Stand in the center. Keep your mouth closed if you have any dental work. Slight vitamin deficiency. I've had some supplements put in your diet. Apart from that, you're in amazingly good shape.
Where do I bunk down?
We have cryo sleep chambers.
Where do I go if I don't want other people around?
We have privacy lounges.
They have locks, I hope.
Yes. I'll show you where the supply section is.
You're a lot younger than your brother was.
9 years. He was a good officer, wasn't he?
Yeah. He was.
I just don't trust him, that's all.
Why not?
Didn't you see the guy? He looks like something dredged out of a waste dump.
Unauthorized personnel on bridge.
Acknowledge. No further action.
So what would further action have been?
Computerized security would have been instantaneously deployed.
That's very clever. Whatever it is.
Priscilla.
Stupid name for a computer.
Well, Dr. Bauman named it after his daughter.
Bauman?
Oh, that's right. You wouldn't know. Dr. Joseph Bauman, he invented this. And
Joseph Bauman? Chubby little guy who talks to himself?
It's how he works things out, by talking to himself.
You mean the guy who was always babbling about running elastic through the universe was right?
Of course. The Bauman drive is what's going to get this ship where it's going.
Bauman drive?
The elastic thread is only the layman's explanation. Technically, it works by...
Careful.
Why, it's not classified.
No. But it took you 5 hours last time you tried to explain it.
I mean, you understand all this stuff.
Of course, I helped develop it.
Now, why didn't I figure that out?
Captain Brown is notorious for misjudging people.
What? You two know each other? Priscilla?
Well, I didn't think it would be polite to mention it.
Well, what exactly is this thing?
It's a computer hooked up into an analog of Priscilla Bauman's brain.
Oh, boy.
So you do know her?
Well, sort of used to go out.
We would have, if you'd ever shown up.
She's not really in there, is she?
No. It's got all her thoughts, all her memories. But the real Priscilla Bauman's back on Earth.
Am I?
Good. Let's try a little more weight. Not bad. That's 180 pounds. More weight, Lonnie? That's great. A little more back into it. There you go. Hurt those pecs.
Trust me, I am.
Yes, sir. You just keep that up. 12 more, Captain. Good. Very good.
Last I heard, there were laws against torture.
Good point. Present yourself for court-martial, Brody.
It's funny. You want me to set you up?
Oh, no, thanks. I'm just browsing.
All crew members are required to work out to maintain muscle tone.
I'm not a crew member.
But what about your body?
What about it?
But you worried about letting it go?
I'm a nice guy. I let it go wherever it wants to. Besides, I only need it to carry my brains around.
You enjoying yourself?
I'm just seeing what a captain's duties are these days.
It's an interesting ship you got here, Captain.
A lot more entertaining than Blue Star Gamma.
How long were you there?
5 years, 7 months, 3 days. Landed right about the time you were starting on solid food.
As a matter of fact, I was in my second year at the Academy.
There you were, bright-eyed, well-scrubbed, your head crammed full of dreams of space and glory, am I right?
Yes.
We were all like that. Reality's a little different, huh?
I still got a lot to learn.
Well, at least you know that much. You're all right, Captain Kidd. Just remember, the books don't teach you everything.
Excuse me, Jonathan. I need to talk to you.
Yeah, what about?
Dr. Eugene. I've been kind of keeping an eye. I think you ought to interrogate him about Captain Forbes' death.
Why?
He hasn't done anything specific. It's just this feeling I've got.
Lonnie, I can't haul the guy in for interrogation just because you got a feeling about him.
My feelings are usually pretty accurate, especially when they're this strong.
I'll think about it, okay?
Lonnie?
Okay.
Where are you going?
I'm scheduled for cryo sleep. Just remember what I said.
That's enough. Good work, Captain. Sorry, I don't know my own strength sometimes. I'll get you some wine.
And the back brace.
You kill me, Captain. You really do.
If you don't kill me first.
Hey, one right after another. Stay healthy, okay?
Earth Star Voyager departed Blue Star Gamma, proceeding on established course. There is a change in life status, sir. Plus one, unidentified.
Well, then. Mr. Krieger, identify the intruder. Only if absolutely necessary will we make contact with Voyager. Interesting development.
Thank you.
something I can do for you, Jake?
Cut that out, Penny. It's contagious.
I'm sorry.
Maybe you ought to go check into cryosleep.
No, I'm fine. I'll just wait until Lonnie gets back on shift. And, after that, there's a series running in the vid lounge, if anyone wants to go.
Huxley, are you going?
Huh?
I could meet you there.
Priscilla, how could you be there if you're here?
Don't be silly. I'm all over the ship.
You are?
Anywhere. Anytime.
I think Priscilla's got a crush on you, Huxley.
Real funny.
Actually, it's not. I mean, it is possible. It's one of the things we were worried about when we put her together.
Beanstalk, what are you telling me?
Well, it's Priscilla Bauman's brain up there. I mean, it's not only got all her thoughts, but her feelings. And, habits.
Anywhere, anytime.
Captain, I've got an unidentified blip.
Configuration?
It's right on the edge of sensors.
Augment.
There it is.
It's on navigation, too, sir. Whatever it is, it's really moving.
Alter course 2 degrees.
It's changed course to match ours.
And what?
They're out of range again, even on augment. But I picked up weapons. Heavy weapons.
What's your arsenal?
Hand weapons only.
Whose idea was that?
Well, we've got the components for long-range weapons. We just haven't been able to sort them all out yet. I mean, it takes months to assemble them.
All right, we got two choices here. We can wait until Mr. X out there catches up with us, or we can make us a weapon.
Like what?
You ever heard of a railgun?
That's practically Stone Age.
Which do you prefer, a non-existent laser weapon or a well-aimed rock?
Captain Brown, we don't even know what the blip is yet. I mean, they might be friendly.
And they might not be. Now, I'll go and scrounge some parts. Set of arms. If they're attached to a brain that knows something, even better.
Take Mr. Beanstalk.
You're kidding.
He's the best.
And what's he gonna be when he grows up?
Still the best.
Come on, infant.
Is the blip still out of range?
Sorry, I can't find it.
Captain?
Jake's fine, shrimp boat.
Beanie's fine, Jake.
Okay. You were saying, Beanie?
You sure you know what you're doing there?
Making a rail gun. You know how they operate?
A series of electromagnetic force fields which amplify consecutively. Most effective when used at close range.
I'll take that as a yes.
Sorry.
You catch on fast.
Soft and primitive.
Just remember what Thoreau said.
Who?
So much for modern education. Thoreau, Henry David, 19th century American writer. Spent a couple of years in the woods, living in a hut by himself.
Why?
Because he wanted to. Believed in getting down to bare basics. Simplify, simplify, simplify.
That's simple, all right.
I'm gonna start taking down specs here.
I already have.
I don't see you writing anything. What is your IQ anyway?
I'm not really sure. It's kind of off the scale.
But you made him crazy at the academy. Research team must have hooked you up to every test monitor they could get their little fingers on.
How'd you know?
Well, I dealt with that sort before. They have a tendency to forget they're fiddling around with real-life human beings. Must have been tough on you.
I met Jonathan in my first year there. He ran interference for me a lot.
Well, what do you think so far?
I think it might work.
Thanks.
Before it's finished.
It is finished. Test mug, please, Mr. Beanstalk.
What's wrong, Jake? Simplify, simplify, simplify.
So now, all we have to do is rig this thing so you can fire the railgun from the bridge. You want to help me with this, too?
Yes, sir.
Jonathan, there's a malfunction in cryosleep sector H9.
Sleep chamber H9.
Below the threshold of consciousness. There's nothing we can do but put her back in cryosleep and give her the chance to heal herself.
What are her chances?
I'm not sure. It's gonna take a long time.
How many people have access codes to the sleep chambers?
Anyone with grade 4 or higher.
Which includes Dr. Eugene, doesn't it?
Yes.
Where is he?
Well, I saw him heading towards the airlock when Jake and I were...
I have an update on my biopsych review.
Very convenient timing on your part, isn't it?
I wasn't satisfied. I kept working on it.
I'll bet you did. And I suppose you found something very weird about, let's say, my profile.
Since you mention it, you do display a tendency towards overcautiousness.
Of course.
According to the review, it's a result of your ability to see all sides of any given question. This is a good quality in a commander, really. But it may eventually lead to a kind of stalling out.
Let me guess here. Found something questionable with everybody. Sally, Huxley, Beanie, Lonnie. Everybody except for yourself, huh?
You want a full rundown?
Please.
Mr. Beanstalk. Beanie, as you insist on calling him, and I should tell you that nickname is a bad idea. He's going through a bad time right now. To call him Beanie, a very childish name, is only going to reinforce his perception of himself as an immature individual.
Captain.
Yeah?
Priscilla, I told you not to bother him now.
You stay put. What's going on, Huxley?
Jonathan, I'm sorry, but Priscilla's having one of her fits up here. She thinks
she knows.
I do not have time for this. What are you two talking about?
She says there's some kind of glitch in that rail dock.
Captain Brown put in a whole bunch of new circuitry in airlock 19. It's not tied in with the main system yet. Something's wrong.
With the gun?
No, with the... Aha.
What?
It's there again, Captain. It's in the airlock, and you better do something.
We're not finished.
Plan, Captain. Just Forbes and Lonnie.
Plan? Come on, Brody. You're not smart enough to think of a plan all by yourself.
You're too sure of that.
Psych profile was forged. Very clever job, I might add. I had to run three different filter programs before I discovered it. I was trying to find you to tell you.
Dr. Eugene, I'm sorry.
For what?
Just sorry, that's all.
Heard about your little party in the airlock. Nice going.
Oh, yeah, I'm doing just great. I got two crewmen floating around in deep space, another in cryo sleep for who knows how long. And it's sheer dumb luck we haven't lost any more.
Sheer dumb luck's the best kind to have sometimes.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, then, well, why don't you just crawl away somewhere and cry about it? I mean, look at the mess you're in. You're an inexperienced captain. You're commanding an inexperienced crew. You're in over your head. Why don't you just quit?
I can't do that.
There you go. Look, kid. Captain. You're bright enough to figure this out for yourself eventually. Right now, you don't have time. So I'm going to explain it to you. You're responsible for everybody on board.
I know.
But self-pity doesn't go along with that.
It's just too bad, but the captain doesn't get that luxury.
What luxuries does he get?
None that I can think of.
Jonathan! Petey found something in the gym. I think you better come take a look.
Captain will be right there, Huxley.
Captain's on his way.
Near as I can figure, it's a particle beam transmitter.
Well, this is what our friends are using to track us.
Smash that thing!
No. Wait a second. They're following that thing's signal. But if it's one place, and we're somewhere else, Mr. Brown, you think your railgun can fire a well-aimed rock?
Give me 10 minutes, Captain.
Huxley. Trajectory input.
Any. And. Fire.
Excuse me, Admiral, but Earthstar Voyager has just radically altered course.
Adjust coordinates accordingly. Huxley, get that ship back on course.
Changing course.
They went for it.
Nice work.
I know. Of course, my pal, the professor there, had a little to do with it. Had a lot to do with it.
Punch me in for 40 pounds.
Yeah, sure.
I guess I'm lucky you can't actually drop these things on your toes.
It's funny. No, I mean it. I never thought I'd laugh at anything you said.
I guess that's pretty much the way everybody feels about me.
Well, you could loosen up a little.
I know that. What I'd say to a patient like me.
What else would you say?
Oh, the usual stuff. Be honest with your emotions.
Oh, be careful with that one. There are times when you can be honest with them. There are times when they just get in the way of your job. Wouldn't you agree, Doctor?
Well, yes. Tell me, Mr. Brown, did you ever think of going into psychiatry?
My own mind's enough for me to handle. Forget Mr. Brown. The name's Jake.
Leland.
Leland?
As any good shrink would say, blame my parents.
You already ran that program.
Yeah, I know. I just like to be sure.
Does he make you nervous?
Who?
How's it going?
Excuse me.
Those engineers up there are crazy. I mean, they didn't know what they were doing. What's the matter with us?
Oh, boy, do I remember that.
What?
First big crush.
Isn't that, that's been weird for you.
Oh, I don't remember a thing about it.
Liar. Mine was back in first year. Remember Professor Morrison?
The bald guy who taught first level math?
I used to pretend I didn't understand the lesson so I could go talk to him in his office.
You're kidding. You?
When I found out he was married with three kids, I quit eating. I was trying to arrange it so that he would find me picturesquely starved to death on his doorstep.
What happened?
I got hungry. What about you? What was your first big crush?
That was a long time ago, Sally.
Was she at the Academy? Marta Johansson.
No.
Well, at least tell me what she looked like.
She was blonde, and she went into medicine.
There's an inter-speak distress signal coming in.
A blip?
No, that's moving away. This is something different. 50,000 miles dead ahead.
Relay the signal.
Nearest craft, please assist. That's it. No ID code.
Priscilla.
Yes, Captain Hayes?
Distress signal report. Can you identify source and vital data?
Well, of course I can.
Some people never change.
Proceed.
The World's Fair.
The what?
Expo tomorrow, most recent and last in a series of world fairs, held year 2020 on a man-made satellite. Huge failure due to cost overruns, financial corruption, and all the usual bureaucratic boondoggle. Abandoned and fired into deep space. We don't like our failures hanging around, do we?
Just the facts, please.
Attendance demographics as follows.
On second thought, terminate access.
We can't ignore a distress signal. It's against regulations.
Yeah, and this whole trip is strictly by the book.
She's right. But don't answer the signal, Les. Don't let them know we're coming. Sally, Huxley, and I will take the shuttle down and investigate. Mr. Beanstalk will be in charge of the ship while we're gone.
I think I'll go along. With the captain's permission, of course.
That's what we've been following, but the scan indicated no sign of Voyager, sir. She's not on course. We know that much.
Continue cross-analysis until located.
Yes, sir.
Although I must say, they seem to be doing quite well without us. This is tomorrow. I think I'll take yesterday.
Huxley, are you getting a direction from the distress signal?
Yeah, that way. And you guys let me know what you find, okay? Just kidding.
Brown. You bet it is.
You're alive. I didn't know anybody else made it off the ship. Who are these kids?
Yeah, they're all right.
How did you get here?
Oh, we brought down the shuttle when we picked
up a ship? You've got a ship?
Yeah.
Then we've got to hurry.
Oh, wait a second, Willie. We picked up a distress signal.
That's theirs. They leave it on so that if any ship comes by, they can lure it down here.
Who is they?
The OTZ. They run this place. We gotta hurry. They'll know you're here.
They can't know. Our telemetry says there are no sensors here.
This is the outlaw technology zone. They know everything.
Let's go.
Challenge the throne.
What's that?
A pit. They throw the losers down it sometimes.
How bad do they have to lose?
Welcome, Jonathan Hayes. We detected your ship several hours ago. I've been expecting you. But not you, Captain Brown.
Vance?
They call him Top Dog now. He runs this place.
You and I got a little unfinished business.
Lock them up!
Badly damaged in the fighting, so they came here, those that were left.
I'm sorry.
You said the OTC runs this place?
Yeah, well, they sure don't look the way I thought they would.
The real work goes on in the labs underground. Those are just the warriors. They live like that to keep in practice.
In practice for what?
I don't know. Never been able to find out. They've got something big planned. Something they call assembly.
Who comes to challenge?
I, Whistlestick Challenge.
Thank you.
can't be beat. Got some kind of magic.
Well, anybody can get beaten.
Verification, Admiral. Object orbiting Expo Tomorrow identified as Earthstar Voyager.
Why did they go there? Never mind. Continue closing.
Can't get a response from the shuttle. They're probably still out exploring. They've been gone 6 hours. Beanie, I have a blip.
Ah, it's bedtime.
Well, it's not the shuttle. It's coming from the opposite direction.
Identification?
No ID, but it matches the record of the one that was chasing us before. Orders, Mr. Beanstalk?
We're gonna need backup on the bridge. Give me navigation, engineering, life science, and communications.
Proposal for you.
Coming from you, it ought to be a winner.
Pity you couldn't command as well as you could talk.
What do you want?
The access codes to the Voyager.
Pretty greedy, Vance. Still haven't paid me for the first ship you stole.
Give me the codes, and I'll let you and your friends live.
Strangest thing, Vance. For some reason, I just don't trust you.
The codes! As you wish. I'll still take the ship.
Oh, you will? Come on, Vance. You may be top dog of this loony carnival, but that doesn't make you anything better than a second-rate thief. Come on, Vance! Anybody can challenge, right? Or is top dog afraid?
I give you 10 minutes to prepare a fight to the death, Jacob Brown.
You got it.
Blip still closing. How long before they get here? 4 hours. Take your positions.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Les, I'm gonna need your help here. We're gonna need to plot a new course, Kenny.
Yes, sir, Beanie.
You're not gonna leave him down there, are you?
Of course not.
Then what are you doing?
We're gonna try to hide.
I hope Jonathan can still find us.
Watch out for the big fella there.
Even for a last meal, this is lousy.
Pick a hand.
Huxley.
Hux, this is no time for fooling around.
All right. No one wants to pick a hand, then I will.
Hux! This one.
Huxley, I could kiss you.
I knew you'd come around sooner or later. Nice work.
Maybe I can get him interested in the fun and games. You watch for your chance, let yourselves out, and scamper for the shuttle.
We all get out of this.
Yeah, right.
Prepare for combat!
If you'll excuse me, I've got a score to settle. You're a good captain. Just remember that. Might even be as good as me one day.
Come on!
Jacob Brown.
Ready as I'll ever be.
Never learn, do you, Vance?